Hello everyone and welcome back to Creative Grandma. This is part two of the farmhouse granny afghan that we're making. I went ahead and worked a little bit ahead on mine, and for this part two we're going to learn how to take all these blocks we made, and I'm going to show you how to join your blocks together, and then I'm going to show you how to join each row together to form this beautiful afghan. So let me get my afghan out of the way. I'm going to set this aside and then I'm going to grab all my blocks. I did not weave my ends in as I suggested because time-wise I was trying to hurry to get this video done, because sometimes these yarns from AC Moore are very seasonal and I'm not sure how long this yarn's going to be out in the store. So I figured I'd hurry up, get the afghan done, and then go back in and when I'm watching TV just weave all those ends in. So this is block one. Block one is the one with the dark outside edge, and block two is the one with the light color on the outside edge. So what we're going to do is I'm going to show you a chart, and this might help you, it may not. This is how I do it when I design a blanket. I chart it out on paper. So this is my dark block here, block number one. So that's one, and then I put the light block beside it. So this is how we're going to line up our row. It's going to be six blocks across. So you can count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And we're going to alternate those colors. First block one for our upper left corner. And then we're going to put a light block. And then we're going to put a dark block, a light block, a dark block, and a light block. So we'll have six blocks going across and we're going to alternate them. And then when we do row two, we're just going to do the reverse. We're going to take the light block and start row two. Then we're going to take a dark block. So it's kind of like a tic-tac-toe pattern. You're just alternating those blocks as you go. So if this helps you, then just get a piece of paper. I'll just leave this up here for a few seconds. Just pause that video and go ahead. You might want to put black, white, black, white, black, white, if that helps you, because the block one again ends with that dark black color and block two ends with that white and silver color. So if that helps you better keep your concentration, then just go black, white, black, white, and then start row two with white and then black. So let's begin now. If you have a preferred method of how you put your blocks together, you can use your method. It doesn't matter. I have my own preferred method of what I do. I single crochet mine together, but you can use whatever method. If you don't have a method, then you can use my method. So let me get these blocks out of here. So we're going to start with your dark colored block, the one with the black border. Let me zoom up just a little bit more for you. And then we're going to take the white block. You're going to have them both laying flat and both with right sides up. And then you're just going to take the block on the right and you're going to fold it on top the block on the left. So what you're doing is you're putting the right sides together. So the wrong side will be facing. If you flip it over, the wrong side will be facing. So again, you have your black block and your white block, both blocks facing up. Just take your white block and flip it over so the right sides are together. And then you're going to come down to this bottom corner, this bottom right-hand corner. Just turn your work and insert your hook into the very first chain of that chain two space. So I'm just going to go like this and find that first chain. Here's my first chain, so you can see the two chains. I'm inserting into that first chain, and then you're going to match it to the stitches on the back. So it's a little hard to see with this black. Here's my last stitch. You want to go into that first chain on the left side of that stitch. Now this is for right-handed instructions, so for left hand, I'm not sure how that would be. So insert your hook and you're matching those chains. Now for my instructions, I use the white and silver to crochet all my blocks together. So that is incorporated in the amount of yarn you need for this Afghan. So you're going to take your white and silver. I leave about a 3 or 4 inch length, and then I work over the end at the top of the block to weave that in. So just take your yarn, take your hook, yarn over, and pull it through that chain. You're just joining your yarn. I'm going to chain one, and I'm going to go right back into that same chain that I started where I pulled that yarn through. You're going to go back into the same one on the back, matching that stitch, and I take that snibbling of yarn that's left over from starting, and I'm going to crochet right over that. And I'm just going to single crochet, yarn over, pull through that stitch, yarn over, and pull through two loops. And let me explain to you why I single crochet my blocks together. Is because if this Afghan ever has a problem where I rip or one of the blocks get tore, then it's so easy to find this first stitch. You just clip, well, the end stitch. When I get over here, you can just clip that end stitch at the top where you fasten off, and you can just rip that right out. And when you crochet a blanket together where you just crochet as you go, you can't do that. It's really hard to repair an Afghan. So I try to think of all the ifs, ands, and buts in the future if you ever wanted to repair an Afghan. Because some of these Afghans, if somebody special made it for you, it's really, you know, near and dear to your heart, and you want to be able to repair it easily. Okay, so let's get on with joining. Insert your hook into that very next chain of that corner. Insert into that chain. You're going to find the chain on the back. Again, this black is a little hard to see, but I can see here's my next stitch, so the chain's in front of it. Insert into that next chain and work right over your end piece of that leftover yarn and work a single crochet. You're going to find your next stitch, and when you're working on this, you're going into the front loop of the stitch. So when you turn your work, you'll see the two stitches. This one's kind of like down underneath because this is the wrong side. So you're going to just go into that front loop of the top square. And then you're going to go into the back loop of the square behind it. So here is that first stitch. I hope this is showing up. I'm so sorry I'm using dark colors with this. You're going to, here's the front loop, here's the back. You want to go right in between those stitches into that back loop. Have your little piece of thread there, and you're going to work over it and work a single crochet. Find your next stitch. Here's your next stitch. You're going to go into that front loop. And if you turn your work, you can see that back loop is down underneath. So just this top loop right here, just under one strand only. Find that back strand of the next stitch. And if you have to, pull that work back. Here is your next stitch. Here's the front loop. Here's the back. You're going right down in between the two and out through the back through one loop only. That's the back loop. And work a single crochet. I'm going to show you a couple more times, and then I'm just going to work across the block. I'm inserting my hook into the front loop of that next stitch, just in that top loop only. I'm going to look behind my work. Here's the next stitch, and I'm going to go underneath that back loop. So you're going to take your hook right down between the front and back, right in the center, and out through the back of one strand only, and then work a single crochet. I'll show you one more time. Insert your hook into the front loop of that next stitch. Just go underneath the front loop, one strand only. You're going to match it up with the stitch behind it. So here's the next stitch. You're going to insert your hook right between the front and back loop, right into the center and out through the back. So you're working under the back loop only, one strand only, and work a single crochet. So now I'm just going to work across. I'm inserting into the front loop of the next stitch and into the back loop of the one directly behind it, matching those stitches up. And I'm working on my end piece of yarn. as I go. It's up to you how far you want to go. You can just leave it there and then trim it. Insert into the front loop of the next stitch, match it up to the one behind, and go into the back loop and single crochet. Insert into the front loop of the next stitch, match it up to the one behind, insert into the back loop only, and work a single crochet. And we're just going to complete that across our block. I'm just going to go ahead and work across to that corner. Whoops, I went under too far. Make sure you go into the back loop only. Sometimes these stitches are a little tight. Front loop of the next stitch. Match it up to the back loop of the stitch behind it on the block underneath. And we're just going to continue working across. That end is finally out of my way. Insert into the front loop of the next stitch, match it up to the back loop of the next, and just continue working across your block. So I'm going to just go ahead and finish working across my block. I will meet you here at this last stitch and show you how to finish in the corner. I'll be right back. I'm over at the corner chain 2 space, and if you look, I finished with a single crochet in that last stitch, and in the back I finished matching it up to that last stitch on the back. You can see the two chains here of the corner, and then you have the two chains here of the front block. We're just going to single crochet in each one of those two chain spaces of the corner, matching stitch for stitch, front and back. Insert into that next chain, match it up to the chain behind, insert into that chain, and work a single crochet. Insert into that next chain, insert into the matching chain behind, and work a single crochet. I'm going to fasten off and secure my work. And then you can just trim that piece off of where you crocheted over the beginning. Now when you open up your block, let me zoom out a little bit more. You'll have a real subtle ridge on your block right here. And I just think that is such a pretty way, because it's not, you know, all tight. It just lays really nicely. I hope you can see that okay. So it just makes a real nice defined light ridge on the Afghan. So if you look at your paper, if you copied it down, we did our dark block. We did our dark block, our light block. Now we need to do a black block and a white block, a black block and a white block. So all you're going to do is you're going to go to the next color. If this is white here, if your edging is white, then you're going to need a black block for the next block. So you just lay your row here. You have the white, you're going to grab your black, and you're going to lay it right next to your white block. You're going to do the same procedure. You're going to flip that black block up over the white block, and you're going to come down to your bottom right-hand corner. So just stick your hook there, turn your work, and then you're going to start the process all over again. We're going to insert our hook into the first chain of that chain 2 space. We're going to match it up to the first chain of the block below. We're going to grab our white and silver yarn, and we're just going to leave about a 3 or 4 inch length, and then we're going to pull that new color through, and we're going to chain one. You're going to insert into that same chain, and you're going to work a single crochet. And again, this is the same method that we just used to join the other two blocks together. You're going to insert into that second chain of that corner. You're going to match it up with the corner underneath. and work your yarn over that end piece to weave it in. It's so much easier. If you don't like doing that, then just leave it hang and secure it with a yarn needle when you're finished. You're going to insert into the front loop of the next stitch, and you're going to insert into the back loop of the matching stitch behind. You're just matching these stitches up, and you're going to single crochet into that stitch. Insert your hook into the front loop of the next stitch. Insert your hook into the back loop of the stitch directly behind that stitch, just matching these stitches up. I'm working over that beginning end of that starting joining yarn, and I'm working a single crochet. So go ahead and single crochet across your block. I will meet you here at the corner. I'll show you how to finish this block one more time, and then you can go ahead and complete your row. I'll be right back. I'm over at my corner chain two space, so I'm going to insert my hook into the first chain, right through that chain, and match it up to the first chain on the square below. And we're going to work a single crochet. You're going to insert into that next chain of that same corner, match it up to the one below, and work a single crochet. I'm going to fasten off my work and secure. I'll weave this in later, and when you open up your block, again, you have that very beautiful subtle ridge right there going through your blocks. It just very, very nice look. Now let me zoom out, and you can see how this looks. I just think it goes together really nice. So now what you're going to do is you're going to finish row one. So remember, when you look at your work, we have the black, the white, the black. So your next block will be the white. You're just going to flip that over, repeat what we did. Then you will need another black block. You'll flip that over and repeat what we just did. And you're going to end with a white block. So I can't get them all in the picture, but you will have a total of six blocks running across row one. You will start with black, you'll add a white, black, white, black, white, for a total of six blocks. So I'm going to go ahead and finish row one, and then I'll be back. I'll get you started on row two. And then when we get row two done, I'm going to show you how to crochet those rows together. So I'll be right back when I get my row finished. I'm back, and I have row one done of our Afghan. Again, if you look at the paper, it's nice if you do this so you can keep track of your layout of your blanket. Now I put block one and two. It might, again, be easier to do black, white, black, white. So you should have six blocks across for row one. You started with black. You have white, black, and you end with a white for a total of six blocks. Now I really can't get them all into the picture. I'll scrunch it. So you have six blocks starting with black and ending with white. So I'm going to set that aside, and then we're going to start row two. So for row two, what I suggest is you grab three of your white blocks, three of your black blocks, because you need three of each color in each row. But what we're going to do now is, again, we're going to reverse the colors. So this is your top left corner of your Afghan. Now we're going to start row two. So row two, we're going to start with square number two, which is the one that ends with the white. So we're going to start with white, and then black, white, black, white, black, for a total of six blocks across. And you're going to put these together in the same manner. So I'm not going to drag the video out by repeating everything again. If you still need help, you can refer back to the beginning of the video where we started row one. Just follow it through, but use the reverse colors. You're going to start with the white. You're going to lay your black square down. You're going to flip it so the right sides are together. And then you're going to come down to this right-hand corner. You're going to insert your hook into that first chain of that corner. So insert into that first chain. You're going to match it up with the chain on the back. And you're going to single crochet in each of those two chains. You're going to single crochet into the front loop of the top block, the back loop of the bottom block. You're going to single crochet across, and you're going to end with a single crochet in each of those two chains, matching it up with the block in the back. You're just going to repeat the process across, and you're just going to join those squares together. Start with the white, add the black, then you add the white, and you're just alternating those colors. Then the black, then the white, and then you're ending with the black. You'll have a total of 6 blocks across. So go ahead and do row 2. And I think it's so much easier if you have a table or if you have a floor big enough that you can lay this on the floor and make sure you're not messing up. Because sometimes, you know, the blocks are so close in color that even I, believe it or not, when I was making this Afghan, messed up on my blocks, had to rip it up and change the colors around. So it's very easy to do. So if you can lay it out like this and make sure that your blocks are in the right order. So if you have a black one here, there should be a white one underneath. If the black's here, there should be a white one beside it. A white one here, a black one beside it. So I think you get the idea of how this was put together. So I'm going to go ahead and put my row 2 together. I'm starting with the white, I'm working across, and I will end with a black block. So let me go ahead and get that finished, and I'll be back, and then we'll continue on with our Afghan. I'm back, and I have rows 1 and rows 2 finished. So again, row 1, you start with the black square, you end with the white. Row 2, you start with the white square, and you end with the black. So let me show you my chart again. So we have just accomplished row 1 and row 2. You should have all your blocks finished. You needed 24 black and 24 white squares. So we did the first 2 rows, and if you look at my graph here that I made, you're just going to repeat rows 1 and 2 3 more times. It goes row 1, row 2, row 1, row 2, row 1, row 2, row 1, 1, 2. You're just repeating that same pattern, creating a checkerboard effect. So now you have to decide, how do you want to put your Afghan together? I found it easier to put my blocks together. I started with row 1, I did that, I set it aside, did row 2, set it aside. But like I said, it's all up to you. So let's begin, and I'm going to show you how to put the rows together, which is almost the same way as putting the blocks together, except we're dealing with these joining seams here. And I'll show you how to go over those joining seams. Very easy to do, and then you'll be able to put your Afghan together. So let's get started on putting our rows together now. So here is row 1, here is row 2. Now I start on the right side, so you're going to have to come clear over to your last blocks of the row, and you're going to do the same thing that you did with your blocks. You're going to lay them right side up in just the way it would look as if it was finished. So this is right side facing of row 1, and this is right side facing of row 2. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my bottom row, and I'm just going to flip it up over top my top row. And yes, please excuse all these crazy ends because I'm trying to get this video done. Now you're going to go right back over to your corner chain 2 space of that first block on the edge. So let me zoom in. We're going to start the same way we did when we put our blocks together. So we're going to start the same way we did when we joined our blocks. We're going to insert our hook into that first chain of that corner on that last end block of our row, and we're going to match it up with the chain below in that same block, in that bottom block. We're going to pull our new color through, and we're going to chain one. We're going to insert back into that same beginning chain, match it up to the one behind, and I'm also working over my end of that starting strand of yarn, and I'm going to crochet a single crochet. Insert your hook into that next chain, match it up to the chain underneath in that bottom block, working over my end strand from that beginning strand, and work a single crochet. And we're going to work in each stitch across to that joining seam. So insert into the front loop of that next stitch, match it to the back loop of the block below, matching those stitches, and work a single crochet. Insert into the front loop of the next stitch, match it to the stitch below, and insert into the back loop of that matching stitch below, and work a single crochet. And again, this is the same method we use to join our blocks together. We're going into the front loop of the top block, and we're going into the back loop of the stitch below, and we're working a single crochet, and we're matching those stitches. So into the front loop of the next stitch, match it to the stitch below, and go into the back loop and work a single crochet. Go ahead and work a single crochet over until you do your last stitch here. You'll see this double crochet stitch here. Once you do that stitch, stop. I'll meet you there, and I'll show you how to work over the joining seam. I single crocheted in each stitch across until I got to that last double crochet right before our joining stitch. So you'll see our joining seam is kind of raised in the air, and I'm going to try to pull this apart so you can see it. You'll have this open space here. You'll have this piece of yarn, the strand of yarn right here, right next to that joining seam. And then you'll notice you'll have that same yarn right here on that side of your joining seam, and you'll have that corner opening here, that big space. So what we're going to do is we're going to not work in this open space. We're going to insert our hook right in that yarn that's right on the edge of that joining seam. So if you follow that joining seam, you're going to go right into the yarn on the side of that seam. And again, you're not going into the corner space. You want to come clear up here to the top and insert under that strand of yarn. You're going to match it up. When you look on the back, you'll see here's the ridge of that joining seam, and here's that piece of yarn. Just find the joining seam first, and then go into that piece of yarn right on the side. Again, you do not want to work in the corner. You want to come up here to this raised piece of yarn right at the edge of that seam. So insert into that yarn and work a single crochet. You're going to jump over this seam, and you're going right into the top, right on the very edge of that seam, into that top piece of yarn. Again, this is the corner chain two space. You do not want to work in that space. You want to come clear up here to this yarn right here on the side of this raised seam. Insert into that strand of yarn, find your seam on the back, or you can look for the corner chain too and just follow it up to the seam, and you'll find that piece of yarn right here. So here's the seam, and you just want to go into that piece of yarn. You do not want to go into that first stitch. You want to go into the strand of yarn over right next to that seam. So do not work in the corner chain too, and do not work in that stitch. You're just coming up to the top of that strand of yarn right on the edge of that seam, and you're going to single crochet. That's all there is to jumping the seam. You're just pulling that seam together and creating a very nice tight fit to your blocks. Then you're going to start all over again. Here's your first double crochet stitch. It's a little hard to see. Here's that corner. Here's your first stitch. go into the front loop of that stitch, match it up to the first stitch on the back. Here's your corner. Here's the first stitch. Insert into the back loop of that stitch and work a single crochet. You're going to single crochet in each stitch across your block. And when you come to the joining seam, just click back on the video and you're going to repeat this process here. When you get to that joining seam, you'll go into that strand of yarn right on the top of the seam. Then you'll jump the seam and go into that strand of yarn right on the other side and make sure it's in the top. Do not work in that corner chain two space. So if you have any problems, just click back on the video and just rewatch this section. So go ahead and single crochet in each stitch across the way I showed you. You're inserting into the front loop of the top stitch and the back loop of the bottom stitch. You're matching those stitches across just like you're crocheting those blocks together. When you get to that joining seam, again, you're going to work into that piece of yarn right on the edge of that seam. Do not work in the corner chain two space. Don't work here. Work up here into this piece of yarn, that strand of yarn right on the edge. Jump your seam. Work your next single crochet into this top strand here on the other side of that seam, and then you just continue again, single crochet in each stitch. Jump back on the video, watch how I do jumping the seam, and work that across to the end of your row. When you get to that ending chain two space of that corner on the last block over here, when you get to this ending block, your very last block, I will meet you here when you do your last stitch, and then I'll show you how to finish the row. Again, if you need help, just click back on the video. I'm going to go ahead and work across my row, and I'll be back when I get to the end. I single crocheted across my row. I got it all single crocheted across, and now I'm over to my ending block, right at that ending chain two space. So I'm going to insert my hook into that first chain of that chain two, match it up to the chain two below into that first chain, work a single crochet, insert into that next chain of that corner, match it up to the second chain below, and work a single crochet. I'm going to fasten off my work. I'm going to secure my end, and then I'm going to open it up and show you what your seam looks like. So when you open it up, you see this beautiful seam going across your rows. And that's what it looks like. Just a very pretty way of putting this blanket together. And it kind of adds just a little bit more texture. It has, I don't know what I want to say, maybe a rope look or just that little bit of twisting in it. It's just a nice look. So that is how you put your rows together. So let me show you the chart one more time. This pattern is available on my website if you wanted to get the pattern. It also helps if you don't know how to read a pattern. You can look at the pattern as you're crocheting along with me, and that also helps teach you how to read a pattern. So far, we made row one, we made row two, and then we joined row two to row one and formed this first section of the Afghan. So basically, you're just going to repeat that three more times, joining together. So I'm going to go ahead and finish putting all my blocks and rows together. I'll crochet that up, and when I get it all done, I'll come back and show you what it looks like. And then part three, I'll come back with a part three and we'll put that border on our Afghan. So I'll be right back after I get all my blocks and rows put together and show you what that looks like. So just follow this chart and continue on until you have all your blocks and rows put together. I'll be right back.
I'm back. I have all my blocks put together. I have all my rows put together. Now it does look unfinished. It's thrown on the floor and it's just there to show you what the finished item looks like after you get your blocks and rows put together. So we have one more step. We have step three to go, and that's putting the border on, and that will be in the next video. Thank you, everyone. I'm going to zoom in and show you how really beautiful this afghan is made using this yarn. I will be back with part three. I will walk you step by step through the border, and then our afghan will be finished. So thank you for stopping by today, crocheting along with me. I just love that we're making this afghan together. So until part three comes out in a few days, thank you, everyone, and as always, happy crocheting!